Hello, everybody, and welcome again. We're on episode 2 today because it is day 2 of our lockdown in South Africa. I'm Karen House and this is Leanne Hunt. And the title for today's episode is A Plan for the Duration. So Leanne, just to let you know, I'm feeling that it's very quiet. I live in a quite a quiet neighborhood, but it's particularly quiet this morning, waking up and finding a silence over the neighborhood.
Yeah.
So how do you think people are coping at the moment, at the start of this lockdown?
I think there's a huge spectrum. Some people are still very much in denial, as we're seeing sort of in reports of people being out on taxi ranks, huddled together, and taxis being crammed, you know, to full capacity. And also we've had reports of sort of not quite mass gatherings, but people out on the street, almost in defiance of what's going on. So that's on the one end of the spectrum. On the other end, I'm picking up that people are taking it very seriously. They've really battened down the hatches. They're doing everything they know to do, and they're pretty worried about how they're going to manage with the next 21 days or so, and hoping like crazy it's not going to go longer.
Yes, yes, I'd say that sounds about what I'm seeing. And how are you coping with it personally, Leanne?
Well, actually, I'm just recovering from a back operation. So in a way, this beginning part suits me quite nicely because I don't have to then recover very fast. besides that, I think I'm, you know, like everybody else, I'm sort of going through the gamut of emotions. You know, on the one hand, contentment, because, you know, I find that I do have a lot of things around me because I normally spend a lot of time at home. So I have my projects on the go. Then of course, on the other end is the worry, because goodness, you know, we just don't know what hits us. And it's so much not the normal, you know, so this difference from what we are accustomed to is just taking the rug out from under our feet. I think also I'm feeling assurance in the authorities that they've got a plan, which gives me a sense of hope. But on, you know, there's also just the sense of bemusement as I see, you know, the efforts of the best prepared governments around the world doing what they can, and still actually the results are pretty scary. So, you know, one does go through the gamut of emotions. I think what ultimately, though, I really draw on my knowledge of human nature, and especially what I've learned about Elizabeth Kubler-Ross's stages of grief and loss, because I think that's what we're all going to go through together. It's just a process, which is sort of, it's unavoidable, actually. This is just the way it's going to be.
Yes, I think ultimately we want to get to that state of contentment and peace, which you indicated in the beginning of what you were saying. So have you got any tips for us, Leanne? Maybe tips that you can give people to adjust to this particular lifestyle at the moment?
Yeah, well, it depends very much where people are at. And I'm going to sort of just take you through the stages of grief and loss. I think if people are at the denial stage, they're not interested in tips. So that's, we'll sort of pass them. If you're in the anger stage, I think you have to find a way of venting your anger, and in a non-destructive way. So depending on what your normal lifestyle is, if you exercise a lot, then maybe some heavy cardio exercise will vent, help you to get rid of that energy. You can punch cushions if it helps you just get rid of that frustration and you just want to punch something. What I like is the idea of choosing a friend that you can sort of maybe debate the situation with. If you have anger, a trusted friend that you can take a stand with and say everything you need to say, but you know that the relationship won't be damaged as a result. Another idea is to write down, perhaps in the form of a letter, all your anger, all your resentment, all your pent-up frustration. Write it, crumple it up and throw it away or burn it or whatever, and make that a sort of a little sacrament, something that you've done for yourself. just avoid expressing your anger in ways that are going to get beyond your control. I always like to think of that, I think it's a Chinese story where the pillow of feathers got ripped open and the feathers spread all over the land, blown by the wind, and it was impossible to pick them up again. That is what the internet's like. If we put out an angry tweet, it can easily get retweeted, and after that, there's absolutely no way to pull it back. So it's those kind of things to guard against. If you're in the next stage of grief and loss, it's the bargaining stage. I think a lot of people are perhaps in that stage or have gone through it and will recognize it when I say it's the stage where you're trying to guarantee some measure of freedom, and maybe you're just pushing the envelope a little bit, you know, hoping that nobody will notice if you go outside. You know, if you just go around the corner and you happen to walk your dog out of sight, maybe you'll get away with it. The bargaining phase is where you just hope that by doing a little bit of good, you can get away with a little bit of something else, and you know, it'll be returned to you. Okay, yeah. And you know. Unfortunately, that's going to be fruitless, because this is a lockdown that if you disobey the regulations and you expose yourself to risk, you may actually either get very ill yourself or you'll infect other people. So it's just not worth the risk. So that period of bargaining is likely to be quite short, and it's going to lead inevitably to depression, where you realize that all your efforts are in vain and you cannot do anything. And so you sit at home on the couch and you think, so what now? Now, depression is a horrible place to be, because you are totally sapped of energy and motivation to do anything. So I think we must understand that it's probably going to be an inevitable part of our process, and to plan for it. So what I like to suggest is, you know, we all know projects are hard to start, kind of get the idea and the motivation and get all the parts together and start the project. But once something's up and running, then to keep going with that project is not difficult. So I'm suggesting start a jigsaw puzzle, start a knitting project, start a painting if you're an artist. You know, if you are interested in nature, start an ant farm. You could perhaps, I know some people might like to learn yoga, or a skill that you've always wanted to pick up. Something that has interested you for years and you've not had the time to do. So start it, get going with it, so that picking up at a later state is not going to be hard. And also in that would be just bookmark a whole lot of websites that you kind of think that will be really interesting to get to, or movies that you want to watch. So they're on your list. And then that depression, if you keep doing sort of the sensible thing and keep yourself moving forward, so that you don't fall into a slump, a rut that is absolutely too deep to get out of, you will ultimately come through to a place of what they call acceptance, where it's literally, this is it, it's the way it's going to be. And you can just live with it, because it's fine. It's fine. It's the best you can, you can do at the moment. Yeah. You've got your little systems going around you, and you know that there is light at the end of the tunnel, but for the duration, this is just the way it's going to be. And then you can start to look at or appreciate all the good moments, you know, having a cup of coffee and putting on your slippers and, you know, sitting in front of the TV and just thinking, this is so nice. I'm just so lucky that I can actually do this. And I've been wanting to do these kind of projects for so long, and now I can actually do them. So recognize that this is going to be a process wherever you start, wherever you find yourself now, and plan for that awful depression, because it probably will come. And look forward to getting out on the other side, which is the acceptance, when you really can start to feel peace and joy in the situation despite the circumstances.
Yes. Wow, that's great. Could you give us those stages once again, just to summarize, please, Lee?
Sure. Yeah. Okay. The first stage is denial, we know what denial is. Second is anger.
Right.
Third is bargaining.
Yeah.
Fourth is depression. That's the nasty one. And the fifth one is acceptance.
Right.
And I always remember it, an acronym DABDA, which is D-A-B-D-A. And that's just the way to you know, fantastic. I like to keep it in my mind for reference.
Yes, and I've seen graphs about it, sort of you dip down and you dip up again. So but I love the tips, and especially the ones around talking to somebody, a trusted person, that you can talk and be honest about your feelings. And the other one I love is the project, is get started. And it could be something self-development, even coming up with a new course that you could offer online, you know, something that you love, or doing a course. So they're projects that are, it's a very exciting opportunity. And to plan for that, as you say, so you know this is coming, so let's start putting some of these steps in place. Thank you so much, Leanne. It's been a lovely chat today. And so we're finishing off day two of our lockdown. And once again, we will see you tomorrow. Have a lovely day. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye, Leanne.